Finally today, I'm here to officially announce that I'm retiring as the basketball coach at Southern New Hampshire University. I've said this, you know, many times before, that coaching is the last breed of cowboy left in this country. You're away from the family. A lot of times you're alone, just like any cowboy back in the old days. And it's time for me. And now, you know, this has been my last roundup. You know, I don't want them to like me. I just hope they can respect me and what we're doing as a group. Three or four times for us this year. As a matter of fact, we beat New Haven at New Haven. Where the faces are so cold, I drive all night just to get back home. I'm a cowboy on a steel horse I ride.
Point. The second round, the game went to overtime. Here in the third game, Bridgeport has a one-point lead with 28 seconds left in the game. New Hampshire College will take a timeout. You can only wonder what Stan Spirou could say now. He better dig deep into his bag of tips right now, because if he doesn't have any tricks left, Bridgeport will win this game. Chris Tate has the ball. 7 seconds, 6 seconds left. New Hampshire College has to shoot. Kirk Jackson takes a shot, he hits it, with 1 second left, New Hampshire College has the lead. High roll, Bridgeport. New Hampshire College leads 84-83 with 1 second left. New Hampshire College takes the ball away at midcourt, and they win the championship. New Hampshire College wins the New England Collegiate Conference Championship, 85-84. They're being mobbed on the floor. Oh boy, there couldn't be a happier moment for New Hampshire College. Their first ever New England Collegiate Conference Championship, and this might well be their best team ever.
Go.
Oh!
Red!
Caught it.
I haven't seen that. It just snapped it right out of his hand.
Man, that strength right there.
What a pass underneath.
They
got
it
for three.
Oh,
holy cow, what a series.
Woo. That's why he's an All-American. Both ends of the floor.
I have never seen that.
Peace.
Deering looking to go second time in a row. Misses it that time. Robertson throws across court.
That's going to be a travel.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Crowd
doesn't like it at all, but I guess you gotta wait for maybe for the man to. Stanley, are you kidding me?
Miss McFadden, no good. Rebound, Boone. And they got Paternostro. Good job of getting back though. He's gonna go anyway.
Oh, he baked him! 1-on-3, Rob with a little banking, lulled him. Oh, nice juke move.
Deering gets caught inside, and that is a coach Sandell.
That's a violation.
Away with it.
That's a violation. There's the jacket.
There goes the jacket.
Staley's running, the jacket's gone. It's a violation. He's on the court, he throws the jacket. A bad call.
And just like that, a 9-point lead turns into a 4-point lead, and LeMoyne has got to be happy going to the locker room, Carm, with that turnaround.
Yeah, oh boy, what a turnaround. The three fouls on Fridge, and Jay's holding back Stanley a little bit.
And I'll tell you what, his turnaround could be a 4-more-point turnaround. He picks up a tee, LeMoyne gets the ball back.
Call a timeout away from the ball. Understand? The other thing is, if the ball is on the floor, it's not just ball.
ball.
Good evening and welcome to the Springfield Civic Center. This is the Elite Eight. The Penmen got here by winning the Northeast region in thrilling fashion. A 79-78 double overtime win against the nation's number one ranked team, Philadelphia Textile. The postseason accolades continue to roll in for the Penmen. Today, head coach Stan Spirou was named the coach of the year in all of Division II basketball.
They're in the man-to-man, but they seem to be trapping quite frequently out of it.
Paternostra with the leaner.
How did that thing go in?
Shot clock down to 10. Wayman off the glass. Fights for the rebound, controlled by Kachar, who puts it up and in.
Big play by Barish.
94-79, 2.5 minutes remaining. Oh, we could be in for some showtime with Arte!
Oh, Arte with the face slammer jammer.
Hey, Cal State Bakersfield, here come the Penmen, baby! 11.7 seconds remaining. And now O'Connell on the break. The
rebound! Jeff throws it home!
The senior, Manchester West! Look at me, baby, I'm going to the Final Four! It's over!
Here come the Penmen! It's over! Final Four, here we come!
100-90, New Hampshire College has defeated Alabama A&M. An impressive performance for the Penmen, and for the second straight year, they will be playing in the Final Four.
Two of the top Division II teams in the entire country, and they're meeting right here in the Granite State.
When these guys play, they're playing for first place in their league. They play three, sometimes four, sometimes even five times a year. They've done that, and the games generally are terrific ball games. So this really is the critical rivalry the Penmen have, and Franklin Pierce has during the course of the year.
Jeffrey, huh? Top of the key, looking, gets Rant back to Rant, 11 seconds on the shot clock.
They should be running the offense now.
And they do. Bino, one-hander over everything. Bino, Ransom, big basket, 68-59, nine-point lead.
If you got the ball, you could do it.
The trick is getting the ball away from him.
6 seconds, final seconds, ticking away, and what has been one heck of a championship basketball game, and the buzzer sounds, and the Penmen of New Hampshire College have won the NECC championship one more time, 81-69. Over the Ravens of Franklin Pierce College in a terrific basketball game. Stan Spirou, in his 13th year at New Hampshire College, gets a big hug from wife Pat.
Stan Spirou joins us now before the men take on Sacred Heart. We're about 5 minutes to game time here. What are your thoughts before a game starts here, Stan?
Well, my thoughts is it a boy or a girl so I can start recruiting in about 16 years?
No comment yet. We're still waiting.
All right,
best
of luck.
Thank you, Stan.
What can we help you save? Enron.
Being a busy basketball coach, I don't have a lot of free time shopping for clothing. That's why I shop at George's. Whether I'm looking for a new suit, a new sport coat, or one of my famous ties, I know George's will have whatever I need. It's a very relaxed atmosphere. Working with their staff, you never feel any pressure to buy. Shopping at George's is a lot more fun than dealing with the referees.
George's Apparel, 675 Elm Street, Manchester.
Spirou getting congratulations and a hug from Athletic Director Chip Pollock and many of his players. Stan Spirou, truly a legend here at New Hampshire College. 300 career wins is what Stanley's being honored for.
I was born to run, I was born for this. Whip, run me like a racehorse, pull me like a ripcord, break me down and build me up. I want to be the slip, word upon your lip.
You
got to be kidding me. How can you make that call from that position? It's going to cost us the game. That is the worst call I've ever seen.
That's it, coach. That's it. 2 minutes in the box. Let's go.
Get me out of here. Why am I in here? Get me out. What did I do to deserve this? Hey, what are you in here for?
Hello and welcome to the Fieldhouse on the campus of Franklin Pierce University in Ringe, New Hampshire, for this afternoon's Northeast 10 Men's Basketball Championship game between the visiting number 6 seed Penn Men of Southern New Hampshire University and the number 4 seed Franklin Pierce University Ravens. Double team comes, he spins the other way, misses off the window. Marrero bounce for Bonsignor with a one-hand slam. Dobrovich kicks back out. Bonsignor moving to the hoop with 10 seconds. Dobrovich, three-pointer from the corner. And Southern New Hampshire goes up by 7 with 6 to shoot. And a long-range three by B.J. Cardarelli with the shot clock running down. Sanders pull-up three, his second long-range make of the half. And he has 12 points all of a sudden. They go all the way in the backcourt to Sanders. 3-2, Cardarelli steps into a three, and he banks it home. B.J. Cardarelli. Guerrero with 4, with 3. Three-pointer, Cardarelli. And that is a huge dagger in the hearts of the Ravens. It's Southern New Hampshire University, the number 6 seed. They come in, and they beat the number 4 seed, Franklin Pierce, 85-74. To become the 2013 Northeast 10 champions.
You know, we pride ourselves as being the best, if not one of the best leagues in the country, and certainly to represent your league as the champ at an NCAA event, I couldn't be happier. You know, we've been fortunate to be in quite a few of these in the past, none recently, but this group really deserves it.
Hey, congratulations, go celebrate your team.
Yeah, but on that Southern New Hampshire side, you look right towards Alexander Dobrovich. He was the spark in that second half. He made some incredible hustle plays. One I remember down on this end of the court, to our right here from the broadcast position, diving out of bounds, saving the basketball, and a lot of key buckets on the offensive end.
To continue possessions, the tip balls, the plays that aren't in the box score, the tip to another player, the getting on the floor and getting a timeout, the getting on the floor and hustling and tapping a ball to somebody else. You're talking about a situation that every team needs. And to get those hustle plays, there's a bunch of players that do it, but that is how you get forward in the NCAA tournament.
So Southern New Hampshire moving on to Tuesday's regional championship game. Now Gilligan wide open, and that's a good look by Bonsignori, who could have taken the shot himself, although they'll tell you that they're in West Haven, as that's blocked away by Bonsignori.
The best block shot men in the conference, one of the best all-time in Penman history.
Cardarelli for three, yes.
The defense on one end leads to the offense on the other.
Mallory behind the back dribble. Carter on the other end, blocked by Bonsignori.
We got a block party here in Springfield. Opted for the quick three as if they feel they're down at the last second.
Bonsignori the touch in the lane. He has 11. Congratulations to the Penn men of Southern New Hampshire University, the 2015 Division II East Regional Champions.
And who would have thought that they'd win by 17 over the defending regional champs?
What's going through your mind right now?
Well, you know, happy, especially, you know, with my grandson, you know, getting a chance to see this. It's special. This is a special group of kids. You know, they took a team that averaged 90 points a game, held them to 58. This team scored 120 once this year. And I couldn't be any happier or prouder of these kids. They deserve it.
It's been a long time, 20 years for us. Back then, I had a few more hairs when we played in Louisville. But after 20 years, you realize how hard
it is to come back. Oh, there you go. My alma mater. It took me a little bit longer to graduate than you, but. That was their four terms, Eisenhower's, Kennedy's, Johnson's.
Sanders, crossover dribble right of the lane, kick out Cardarelli, down to two. Cardarelli in the lane, his runner is good!
They gonna talk about me. I'm gonna be very legendary. Make way for me. Make way for me. You know I'm gonna be legendary. Make way for me. Make way for me. You know I'm gonna be legendary. Are you ready?
Championship Saturday in the Northeast 10 as we come to you from the Dana Center on the campus of Bentley University in Waltham, Mass. For this afternoon's Northeast 10 Men's Basketball Championship between the Penn Men of Southern New Hampshire University and the Bentley University Falcons. Devin Gilligan handing off Sanders, three-pointer, and the best three-point shooter in the country. Andrews in the corner, Cardarelli the answer! And that will do it. Southern New Hampshire is your 2016 Northeast 10 champion.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road.
I have to give the students, you know, a lot of credit. You know, we've always had, you know, great community support, and I thought the student section today, you know, coming out and in great numbers, you know, gave us, you know, the energy that we needed.
Man, Stan Spirou has been one of the great coaches in the region for a very long time, over 600 wins, continues to crank out great teams.
He's been spectacular. You think about this program, you think about this school, it starts and ends right there with Mr. Stan Spirou.
I don't need to chase anymore any championships. I don't need to win any league trophies, to win any regionals. Right now, what I want to do is hopefully become the best Papu in America next year. And for those of you that never took Western Civ, Papu in English means grandfather. I have six grandkids. That means much. I just don't want to miss that second generation anymore.